Hi, this is Rich. How you doing? Let's talk about the real matrix and are you in it? Okay? All right. So let's define the matrix. Generally speaking, a matrix is a structure within which something else is embedded. So we have a matrix, and what's embedded? You and I. Okay? There's different kinds of matrices or matrixes. But in the movie, all the beings that were stuck in the matrix, in consciousness, they were embedded in that structure, the matrix. And so, in the movie, the matrix is a created world in which beings, people are embedded, or they're put in the matrix in consciousness. They don't know it's a matrix. It feels like the real thing, and they go on living their life. Like, who hasn't seen the matrix, right? Okay, so the question comes up, are we in a matrix? And if we were, or if we are, how can we tell? Okay. Pick me. Let me, I'll tell you how. I know. Oh, yeah. All right. Now, I know for myself that this is a matrix world and we're in it. But how would you figure it out? Okay. There's so much to say about this. I really don't know where to start. Okay? Let's start with this, though, or continue with the startup in the beginning of this, like this. A reality system, or a system of reality, like physical reality, it is a matrix, period. By definition, we're embedded in this physical reality experience from a plane of existence or a place in consciousness that is beyond this vibrational experience, the matrix of the physical universe. Okay, but when you leave the physical universe, your body drops dead, you leave the body and you change vibration, you're in another world or another energy system, another astral plane, another dimension, a universe, something. Each plane, dimension, realm, or universe, a reality system, is in itself a matrix. Okay, so there's always, if you're in it, it's an environment of some sort. You could call it a matrix. Okay, so with this clarity or this understanding, and you don't have to believe this or believe it this way, I'm just saying, with this foundational understanding of what a matrix is, we can see that all experience in consciousness, when you are within a structure that is looks like an environment to you, looks like mountains to me and an ocean over there, looks like the sky, looks like stars and empty space except for some built stars over there and a planet over there and I'm in my spaceship here and all this stuff. This experience, this structure around you that you call reality or life, stuff, touchy feeling. These are called matrices or matrices. Or matrici or matri. Anyway, this sounds like fun and cute and ha ha ha, but in fact, what if you really are in a matrix and not in, okay. See, in the movie, the matrix was a bad thing. And it was a bad thing, not because life in the matrix was so bad. It was actually a little more pleasant in some ways than the real world, right? But in the matrix, what made it bad was that the people in the matrix didn't know they were in a matrix, one. And two, the controllers of the Matrix could do anything they want. Whereas the people that were in the dark, unenlightened, unaware, couldn't do anything they want. And they were the effect of those in control. That's what made the Matrix in the movie not a good thing, mainly. Okay. So, living the real life seemed to be a better deal than being enslaved by the controllers in such a way that you didn't even know you were in a prison or enslaved. But there you were. Okay? All right. So, if you're looking at the movie sort of thing, when you get out of the Matrix there, you're in the real world. But the real world itself, by definition, is another kind of Matrix. It's just more real. Okay. That said, this world we're in right now, this physical universe that you and I are in, when you croak, when you drop dead, you are going to be in another realm. Now, how do you say this? It's quite possible that we are in a matrix just like in the movie. Okay, in other words, we are in a matrix where we don't know that we're in one. There are controllers, are those outside of the matrix that want to keep us in the matrix and keep us unaware that there is a greater reality outside this matrix that we call the physical universe. Okay, and so that's what this video here is about. It's about this one thing. And I say, yeah, in this regard, we are in a matrix here, physical world, matrix. Now, I've had quite a few out-of-body experiences, and I have been talking with people over the last about at least 10 years, longer really, with other people, 15 years maybe, other people who have gone out of body, and people share their out-of-body experiences with me a lot. And it's my own personal experiences when I'm out of this world, the physical reality system, the matrix, and I'm into another realm, that I encounter a greater reality. It's more real than this place. So that's part of it's part of our definition or part of the okay. Now, is that place better than this place? When I say that place, there is more than one realm, reality system, universe, dimension beyond this one physical universe, reality system, matrix. Okay. When we drop dead and leave this place here on planet Earth, beings on other planets, when they drop dead, they can probably move into the other realms and maybe not be just fine and do what they want there, re-enter the physical universe, leave it when they want, go out of body whenever they want, incarnate or not incarnate into a physical form if and when they want. Freedom of choice, full awareness, they're doing fine. So it's not that the matrix that is bad relative to the physical universe being a matrix. It's the inability to freely move into it or move out of it that makes it bad. Or the just not even knowing that you're in a matrix is not healthy. because then you can be taken advantage of, and those outside the matrix can affect your freedoms. In other words, you might want to be free of this matrix, and you try to leave. There are those outside this matrix, the physical universe, that do not want you outside this matrix. They want you back in the matrix, dude. Back you go. So our freedoms are being limited. Our awareness and consciousness and understanding of the greater reality is being compromised and limited. So we got to ask who's doing it and why they're doing it and how do you know this rich? Okay. Well, first, if I can remember all three of those questions, let me talk about the proof, the evidence. Testimonial evidence, personal experience evidence. People have gone out of body, and they share these stories with me, right? They go out of body, and a very typical kind of scenario is their body's asleep here in the matrix. They fall asleep, and they wake up in another world. So they've gotten out of this matrix. Okay. But now the world they are in is more real, touchy-feely more real. You know, visual, crystal clear. Touch things. You can feel the textures. You can just everything. You got to focus. Pay attention. But as soon as you tune in to a particular perception, touch, feel, temperature, distance, space, smells, tastes, everything, hearing, emotions. You tune in, you really experience it, and it's as real as this place ever was, and more so. All right. Now, in those worlds, people encounter, when they go out of body, they encounter extraterrestrials, ETs, aliens, on spaceships, space stations, or just little locations. We don't know where we are. Stainless steel tables, all kinds of things. And in these places, the person that's having the out-of-body experience or the out-of-matrix experience is being corralled and messed with their mind, programming them, throwing mental image pictures at them, thoughts, beliefs, things like this. They're programming the people in such a way that the individual ends up coming back to the physical world with a memory block. They remember being on the table. They remember their vaguely their out-of-body experience. Something about being at a table, or I was in a beauty salon, and I had, and the woman might say, and I had this thing over my head. And somebody else might say, I was on a ship and I was just laying there on a steel table, and there's lots of people there on steel tables, and these things were hooked up to their head. Somebody else, I was in this room with this ET alien looking grayish guy, and I was strapped in a chair, and another ET taller, he walks in, and then some human guy walks in, he's in a doctor outfit. And another one was, I woke up in this, it seemed like, I think I was in a spaceship, and it was in this big auditorium, and we're all sitting in front of computer monitors, and we're all got these things we're supposed to be doing. This experience after experience, my own and other people's. Okay. The common theme in this is that the people would come back after their out-of-body experience, their consciousness shift out of this matrix. They come back, and they weren't supposed to remember, but they did. And sometimes I would help them with different tricks, recall, and kind of like a past life regression, but it was, you know, into their out-of-body experience, and sometimes it's kind of similar to hypnosis. Anyway, recalling, helping them recall and recount the occluded parts of their experience. And this information comes out. And it's like, the theme is that we are being duped. As physical humans, we are able to lift out, shift out of this matrix. But sometimes, not all the time, but sometimes people will arrive in another realm, a greater reality, except there are people there grabbing you up, corralling you, and mind-fucking you so you don't remember what's going on, and they send you right back. These beings, entities, ETs, do not want you to know that you are living in a matrix world and there is a greater world out there where they live. They live and they do life large. And everybody's having a great time living life large in the greater reality, except us schmucks on planet the fuck Earth. We, whenever we get out of body, they would love it if we don't remember the out of body experience, or we think it's a dream, not real, not really happening, and they would love us to not be able to recall it at all. And they love to put fake memories. The woman, she thought she had a hair, you know, when she first got in touch with it, as I helped her recount the experience in a session, you know, close your eyes, relax, move back to that incident, that sort of thing. Mm-hmm. She's seen herself sitting in a like a health spa, and she's got the hair dryer thing on her head. As the imagery became clearer and her mind cleared up, she was on a table in a lab, and this was stuff hooked up to her head and her brain in the higher, greater reality. And they were overlaying this bullshit story so her memory would not be clear. So yet one more testimonial evidence, first-hand eyewitness reports, that we are getting out of this matrix, physical universe, that we call reality, into a greater reality. And unlike the movie, the greater reality is much nicer than in the movie. It's like, wow, there's so much going on. We live life differently. Time is a little different. No pain. Not in the greater realities that I've experienced and I go to. You have sensation and all this stuff, but you don't have the, ow, that hurt. Now, some people have reported, a few, two or three, four, five maybe, in all these years. They said, no, Rich, when you go out of body, you know, and all that, and you can feel pain. I go, not where the fuck I go. I've tried it. I've taken a fucking knife. And he went, that didn't hurt. I'm just kidding. That didn't hurt. I've cut myself on the finger just to see myself freaking bleed over there. Do I have blood over here? Blood, drip, drip, drip. Cool. And can I, with a will, you know, heal myself? Yeah. Oh, cool. So over the years, what I've concluded about the greater reality is that people like you and I, we are like ascended masters or avatars, magi, magicians, genies out of the bottle. We are incredibly able and powerful in consciousness in these greater realities, in these other realms. We can literally manifest things with a thought over there. While the local inhabitants maybe cannot do this. So it's almost like the beings on planet Earth We're incredibly powerful genies in a freaking bottle, and they're keeping us in the bottle, in this matrix. And it's not just on planet Earth, it's just that on planet Earth is where they throw us, and this is where we end up. And when we try to get shift consciousness to the higher planes, they're all over us, man. They're like watching us like, you know, like hawks. It's like, whoa, they got out. Oh, he got out. Oh, she got out. Oh, she woke up. People are all the time writing to me. And they say, and they wake up in the middle of the night in their bedroom, except they've shifted. Now they're in the, they're in another plane. They're in the astral plane or etheric plane. You know, just some other real-time double. There's all these labels for it. But what they do is they wake up. And there's entities. There's beings. There's yucky-looking things. Or there's humans and are, you know, men in black and these dark robed cloaked beings with these little red light being eyes looking at you, and they're just creepy as fucking hell. It's like, what the fuck are you doing in my fucking house? They want to keep us in the matrix. They're watching us, seeing us when we wake up out of this matrix world, and we're like, oh. And yeah, it's unusual and crazy and wild and weird sometimes for a person having their first few out-of-body experiences. But we are incredibly powerful. We can literally change their form. Not everyone, not every time. It depends on who you are, who they are, and what plane or dimension you are in when you shift consciousness and you experience your out-of-body experience, your astral travel, your consciousness shift into another world, alternate reality, parallel universe. It depends on a lot of things. But a lot of times, for most people, if you're laying in bed and you go, oh, this is weird, and you can lift your hand out of your body, ooh, or you look and there's some creepo in your bedroom, shadow being, man in black, giant, you know, 7 foot tall reptilian. Literally, people write in and tell me about this stuff. With your mind, oftentimes, with your power to create, you can literally change their form. Or you can flow them love and just watch them go all fucking nut bar on you because they don't like that love shit. They're out of here. Or this one guy had these little things crawling up his legs. It's all creepy and shit, right? And this happened more than once. And he asked me, what do you do? And I said, well, flow it some love, see what happens. So it happened again. And he flows these little creepy things crawling up his freaking leg. Kind of like in the astral plane, right? And he's laying in his bed, and it's real and more real than real. These worlds, I just cannot say this enough. This, we call this reality, yeah, because we can touch and feel it. Oh, I can touch and feel it and see it and smell it, and it persists here, and there it is, and look, knock, knock, knock. It's here. This is reality, man. Yeah. Well, those worlds are more of this, more real in that way. So anyway, this thing's crawling up, this guy's... And he flows it love. And it turns into some warm, fuzzy, fluffy little thing. And it gets all friendly and fuzzy. Kind of like a little kitty cat or a little fuzzy something, you know, furry animal. All loving and friendly, pet-like. Whoa. And he did that with love. We are incredibly, incredibly powerful beings. So, now I'm trying to think of something I thought of a second ago and I wanted to mention and talk about. And I don't remember what it is. Whoa. But, yeah, I get pretty cranked up and excited about this sometimes. Now, I've mentioned this in other videos, so, and you probably heard, oh, he's talking about that one again. Where I wake up, and I'm in this other world, it's like a little jailhouse, you know, Andy of Mayberry and all that little sort of deal. And I didn't want to be in the jailhouse because what it really was a place where they gathered people who got out of their dimension, where they're supposed to be. And they maybe didn't all of them come from the physical dimension that I have to come from. But there I was in their world. Ooh, their world. And they say, hey, it's like they gather us up. They throw us in a little jail cell, which is really a portal back into our other world. So, boom. And so... You arrive back in your physical body in the other world. At least human types do. I don't know what those other guys were doing. But I didn't like being captured. I didn't like being told, hey, You're trespassing. You're not wanted here. So I took off running. I jumped over the little rail and out the front door and took off down the road. And they came after me. They chased after me. Another time, I'm being, once again, they find out, hey, you're not supposed to be here. What are you doing here? And they literally want to take me and send me back to the physical world, the Matrix. This is, various people write these accounts. And these aren't the, see, there's the kind where you get out of your body and you end up on a spacecraft or with the ETs, the aliens, the bad boys, that they do not want you waking up and experiencing the greater reality that they live in. Fourth density, with whatever label you put on it, they don't like it when we arrive in their world. So, and they want to keep us down, dumbed down and ignorant and back here. So that's what they do. They do it with their technology and mind control stuff and all that. But other times, you can go out of your body, arrive in a different plane of existence. Like, wow, you're in some world somewhere. Now, depends on where you are. Sometimes the world, and it might be the whole realm, the whole universe, or the whole belief system territory, the reality system, it might be they can tell that you don't belong there. You're an interloper. You're not a regular. You're not a local. You're not a native. There he is, boys! Get him! And so you're in one of these chase scenes. You might think it's a dream when you're being chased. What the hell am I? I'm always being chased. Yeah, you're in somebody else's, possibly. You're in somebody else's dream world. You're in somebody else's reality system. You're in somebody else's matrix. They're all matrices. They're all matrixes. Every world, every dimension, every reality, every plane, every universe. A matrix. But we know what we're talking about. We're talking about the kind of matrix where you're in, you don't know you're in, they won't let you out. That's what we're talking about here. So, all these matrices are also, am I saying that word, matrices? I don't know. Lexi? Lexus? Lexuses? I don't care. Anyway. Oh, the one I don't like is focus. One focus. If you got two focuses, it's foci. I can't stand that word for some reason. Anyway. Moving right along. These matrices are also dreamscapes. This physical reality system is a dreamscape. Now, we can easily understand what a dream is and a dreamscape is, right? Easy sneezy. A dream is something you create with consciousness. Maybe on automatic, you don't really know you're doing it or how you're doing it, but you know you're doing it. We assume we're doing it. We conclude, we draw that conclusion. I got to be doing this because it's just me, man. Mm-hmm. Well, sometimes beings, we are like this. We can have a dream, a mutual dream, with another being. And people have written into me about this. Me and my best friend, me and my sister, me and my buddies, we get together and we have these mutual dreams. We have out-of-body experiences together. Or it's accidental. Me, I had this dream with my friend. It seemed so real. I called up my friend. Or they called me up and they confirmed it. We compared notes. We had the dream together. Yeah, so it's a co-created dream. The two of you together are creating that environment, that dreamscape, that matrix. So these matrixes are created with consciousness. And we all have to create or contribute to the creation of something before we can experience it, before we can see it, feel it, hear it, or whatever. So this here, this pen, I am literally creating it in consciousness, just like I was closing my eyes and imagining the pen in my hand. I am doing that when I'm looking at this. It's like this world around us, you can call it a template, or template reality, or template dreamscape, or template matrix. And when we tune into a realm, world, dimension, reality, universe, Matrix, Dreamscape. We literally tune in on some grand, we just focus in, and we contribute to its creation on a subconscious level. And we're creating the whole thing with everyone else. It's like they've taken the lead, but we just tune into them. It's like you're sitting there with a friend, and you have great visualization. They have great visualization skills. And they go, hey, let me tell you, I want you to close your eyes and think of an apple. And they go, okay. And the person sharing the thought imagines a particular red apple with a big leaf on it and a big stem, and it's a really delicious looking apple. Yay, and it's red. Yay. And the idea is that I want you to telepathically see the apple that I'm imagining, not a green apple. Okay? So, buddy, yeah. And if you tune in properly, this person will see your mental imagery, the exact same stuff. But in order to see it, they literally are creating it in their own consciousness. This is how psychics do it. They tune into people, and they see the visions. And they can tune in into the now, into the future, into the past, all kinds of great things. But it's all in consciousness. And when the psychic or the clairvoyant sees something, they are creating it with their own mind. Ta-da! It's a no-brainer that we create worlds, universes, dreamscapes, reality systems, and matrices with consciousness, with our own minds and thoughts. Doing it deliberately and consciously, that's a little weirder. But I have met people and worked with people who can do this. They can create an environment around them. I close your eyes. Okay. Now imagine this. Okay. Imagine a beach. Yeah. Okay. The waves. Yeah. Oh, I hear birds. I work with these people, and their ability to see, feel, touch, and experience their dreamscape, their imaginary daydream world, enhances. It gets better and better. We have a scale of 1 to 10. 10 being as real as the physical world. One being just a little image, kind of vague-ish, almost invisible. 10, as real as the physical world. I work with these people, and the environment gets 11. Visual, 11, 12. Audio, oh, 12. You mean you could hear things more clearly than in the physical world? Oh, yeah. Hear the birds, hear the water. I smell the sea breeze. I can see all the grains of sand, and they're doing a visualization while I'm talking with them. Okay. So this is, to me, absolute proof that we create worlds so easily, instantly. So physical reality is nothing more than a massive dreamscape creation in consciousness that you are creating right now as you look around and see it. But so is everybody else. And it's on this deep, weird level that's pretty much incomprehensible how it's being done exactly. The details. Weird. But not so weird because you look in your own dreams and you see the same thing happening. Here comes a car. Just came around the corner. It's driving by you. It's a real pretty car, too. It's one of those old classic Cadillacs or something. Wow. How did you do that? You don't know, but you did it. And if it's a lucid dream, you go, whoa, 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 hold it. And you can stop it with your thoughts. And you can even change it, transform it into a Chevy or a horse. How do you do that? With a thought. So we have this as our go-to place for understanding that this is possible. So your matrix, this physical world, in itself is not a bad thing. And if you lived on another planet, some advanced civilization where they are teaching all the metaphysical stuff, in other words, the things beyond the physical world, in other words, things outside the matrix, you could probably figure it out or conclude that, oh, these advanced civilization beings, wholesome, loving, compassionate, sharing, and teaching their children how things work, you know, oh, look, how nice. They come into the physical matrix and they play. They experience life here because of its particular flavor and intensity and vibration. And they enjoy their living experience and they learn and they evolve. And, oh, it's so much fun living in the physical reality system off planet. Okay. And when their physical body croaks, or even before, they are able to leave the physical universe matrix. They're not trapped here. And when they leave, they don't encounter dark beings, men in black, and, you know, in the astral plane, and they don't shadow beings and entities and incubus and succubus and all this crazy fucking crap that we sometimes can experience. I'm not saying everybody does. Not by a long shot. It's just these icky weird experiences, encounters, are what get most of the press. You know, hey, oh, I saw a bunny rabbit. Big deal. I saw, oh, yeah, oh, everybody's talking about that one. Okay. So, on these other planets, oh, I see, I get it, yeah, it's not so bad. So, it's only my premise or my hypothesis is that on our planet and other planets like ours throughout the universe, there are beings in the higher planes, fourth density, fifth density, wherever, somewhere one of these vibrations above the physical reality vibration, and they are particularly interested in keeping the beings that are in physical form, in physical reality, ignorant. They want to keep us ignorant of the greater reality. They want to keep us locked into the matrix here for their own reasons, all these different reasons. They want to keep us here. So, especially here on Earth, when you have an out-of-body experience or a lucid dream, sometimes a dream is actually an out-of-body experience. You're in another world, just you're too asleep in the now during it to understand that it's more than just a dream. And in fact, physical reality is just a dream. It's really a mind fuck around here. And that's another thing that they do. I believe that the powers that be will not allow us the right, a good education on understanding reality and metaphysics, metaphysical reality, reality beyond the physical world. So that we think dreams are dreams and reality is reality. In fact, realities are dreamscapes. And all dreams are real. You can touch them. You can feel them. You can experience them. And if you're awake in the now, in your dream, it becomes a lucid dream. By definition. One of the definitions. And if it's a lucid dream, it's a clear dream, you can clear thinking in your dream, you're lucid. There's a lot of light, you're enlightened. Ooh, dreaming, ah, I know it, I'm dreaming, ah. Yeah, and sometimes you can change the landscape and the environment with thought. Yeah, you're becoming empowered. And you're able to do things with thought, with intention. You're becoming a master of the universe. So sure, they don't want us awakening into their world with all our great powers and understanding of how powerful we really are. We'll mess up the works. Especially if we go over there and we're a little irresponsible or we're children about the whole thing. We go, oh, look, a building. I think, okay, and you crunch their building with a thought. That's not nice. I mean, you are the bad guy and don't even know it. Ooh, sorry. But we don't even think sorry. We think we're just fooling around here in a dream. And we're these big, clumsy, powerful beings going into somebody else. This is possible. I'm not saying it happens to you all the time or it ever will. But you could arrive in somebody's world, their belief system territory, and you have more power than they do. And you go, oh, look. And you change something in their environment that the locals really like. They like it just the way it is. And you go and change it. And it's like, hey, get the hell out of here. What are you doing? And so they go, and they kind of grab you, and they'll chuck you back to your world until you grow up. till you understand what's really going on. It's kind of like that. So in that way, we, humanity, were naive and ignorant. And I don't think it's because we're naive and ignorant about how realities work and how their world works and how to behave in a civilized manner in their world. And so, of course, they don't want us there. And we're dangerous to them. Right? We're not causing pain, but we cause damage. Okay. And again, it depends on where you're at. They can reform their world back the way it was after you, with a thought, changed their pretty little village fountain from a horse into a big bear because you wanted to. And they go, what the hell? And they look at it and they reimagine it back the way it was, and it just transformed. But, you know, it's like, what are you doing? You're changing. This is our place. You don't do that. Oh, sorry. Or, it's fun. So, anyway, we have a lot of growing up in that way to do sometimes. But what I'm saying is, it's not always about growing up. It's about, we are here in this incarnation and having had thousands and thousands of past lives cycling into physical reality. With each time we're ignorant of our last life. Each time we're ignorant of our last life, we don't remember our past lives. Well, this is freaking ridiculous. So this tells me, this is my hypothesis, my premises, my thought for the day. We are being recycled, powerful beings being recycled back into physical reality. And each time it's a brand new learning experience. We don't even know how to talk again. We're back at, we don't even know how to talk. In the first few years of our life, we're just getting up to speed. And we remember nothing of our past lives. We should have thousands and thousands and thousands of lifetimes or millions of years of experience to rely upon to help us understand who we are, what we are, and how powerful we are. Because we can walk into these other realms and just change things up real fast. And maybe the locals cannot do that. So it's like, yeah, get that dangerous, ignorant motherfucker out of here. And boom, 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 and they shoot us through the portal, and we wake back up in our physical world going, whoa, what was that? Was that a dream, a lucid dream? Was that an out-of-body experience? That was so weird. They were chasing me. Well, the ETs, they're playing another mind game on us. They are the ones, some of these ETs, extraterrestrial bad boys, I believe, are catching us. And they're the ones that are they're part of the program of spinning us back into physical reality with no memory. This is a big problem. We shouldn't be blank. We should have our memory and understand what's going on. We should understand our relationship with physical reality, the greater reality, third density, fourth density, fifth density, alternate reality, parallel universes, belief system territories, energy systems, locale two, whatever you want to call it, lower astral, middle astral, upper astral, causal plane, mental plane, emotional plane, all these labels for all these places. We should be up to speed. Because unless you're a brand spanking new baby being who just manifested as a spark of your mother, father, creator beingness that was you, and now you're the little you that was the big you, and your big you gave you a new point of view from which to become the great being that you can be with just a little experience. Here you are with no memory of anything. Why the hell would they do that? That's not cool. So it might be that, but you might have been here for gazillions of years, coming back in the physical world, playing around in this planet, other planets, but you're always physical reality, and you're going up there. You're popping out of this place, this matrix world, and you're getting into some shit. It might be cool shit, and it might be crappy crap shit, but you're getting into some stuff, and then you're back in here, and you're, hey, I'm alive, yay. No memory, bad idea. So we have to ask ourselves, is this a matrix? Are we being recycled? Are we being made to not remember our greater reality outside of this matrix and continually cycled back in? And if so, why? Well, the whole whys and the details of the whys, different story. But the short story, just so you know, like, well, why, Rick? These beings, they like being in control and power where they are in the greater realities. They're into the control and domination trip. So, of course, they don't want a powerful being like you. Pata, is that what they call it? Alex Collier talks about how incredibly powerful and advanced we are. So here we are. Now, how do they, in this greater reality, that is the real reality, this being the matrix, like in the movie, this is the matrix, and that's the real reality. They got real beings doing real things, really real, really, right now, doing things to make sure we stay here thinking this is the real reality. And this is a cheap knockoff, as far as I'm concerned. But they're all... I could just go on all day long talking about this shit, couldn't I? Yeah. Okay, so... they don't want us waking up, becoming aware, and getting in touch with our greatness and our power. Because they couldn't control or dominate us, and their game would be blown. The game is the game. The game is control and domination for certain kinds of beings. In this reality system and in the higher reality system. And a lot of beings in this plane of existence, advanced races of ET, not the good guys, are completely aware that this world is a matrix, or this universe is a matrix universe kind of place. And they get, not only do they get that there's a higher density, a higher vibration from which they came, they come and go as they please. So they get to play life large in two reality systems easily. And they get to play king of the mountain, queen of the hill, mountain, whatever. And they don't want the likes of us waking up and beating their ass at that game, because we can. We are able to look a reptilian in the fucking face in these higher planes, and turn that lizard into a fucking monkey. Really? I've talked to people who have these abilities. They get out of their body and they have these encounters with these creepy mothers. And, you know, hey, try this, do this. You know? And they do it and win. Win-win. It's like we are so powerful in that way. We just need to be in touch with that power, understanding that. So we are kept down and dumb and ignorant on this plane of existence, in this matrix, for this is one reason, one more reason why we are, why they do that to us. How is that for a wonderful rap? That's a rap! I hope you liked, I hope you enjoyed me going crazy on this stuff, and, blabbing it up like this. I kind of had fun doing it. Your comments are welcome. And yap it up. And I hope this helps you think outside the box and have a little more of an empowering perspective while in this physical universe matrix, and if and when you ever shift out of here into a higher, greater realm, dreamscape, reality system, energy system, parallel universe, alternate reality, matrix, place, yay, hi, be all you can be, baby. I say love, compassion, understanding. What are some other values? Integrity, honor. Honor among thieves! No. Yes. No. What are values we have going that, truth, understanding, comprehension, freedom, liberty. And I don't mean global freedom, you're free to hurt others. No. That's why this is called a free will universe. Because, in fact, you do have the free will to hurt others. That's not good. God, now I want to go off on a fucking tangent about how the whole physical universe experience was a grand experiment. It fucked up. Yeah, this place fucked up because the experiment fucked up. The original plan was supposed to be all wonderful and love and light and a creation and evolution of spirit and consciousness. It's all going to be great. The way we spun it and played it allowed for beings, very powerful beings like us, who didn't give a flying fuck about you or me, your feelings or my feelings. And in fact, they get off on controlling and dominating other beings. And part of that get off on dominating and controlling other beings is mind fucking us into believing limiting beliefs that just keep us getting weaker and weaker, less and less empowered throughout the millennia, throughout the millions and millions of years of our existence. We keep spiraling down, 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 less and less aware, less and less understanding. But this is a grand scale game for these other powerful beings who are on the winning side, who don't give a shit about our feelings, our emotions, our sensibilities, our freedoms, our rights, our consciousness. They love the control and domination game. And that's what we're up against on planet Earth and physical reality and their counterparts in the greater reality. And they are in cahoots. There are those on this planet who are empowering, excuse me, there are those on this planet who are in power and working us control domination game, enslave the planet, enslave consciousness, enslave humanity, keeps in the dark, while their counterparts, their friends in the higher planes, are helping as best they can. Because in fact, that is the real reality, the greater reality. And they're helping their boys here. This is like what's it, Mr. Smith's in this matrix are trying to ramrod and keep the rest of us in the dark. Okay, so it becomes our job to wake up, get out of the dark, see the light, in other words, see the truth. And what I'm offering you are some possibilities, some new ways of looking at things. Things to consider, and you decide what the truth is. You make up your own truth. You believe what you do, empower yourself, and may the best man or woman win at awakening and helping the rest of us awaken. Ta-da! To the greater reality and understanding and freedom. And can I go now? Oh, okay, good, good, because I'm getting red here, China. I'm getting all fucking. Can't even fucking stop damn camera here. Ooh, I just got fuzzy. Did you see that? Okay, man. Okay, gal. I'll talk to you later. Thanks for watching my wild and crazy rant and babble. Okay. I will talk to you later, okay? Thanks for watching. You're the best. Bye-bye.